Welcome to the ThinkCell tutorials. This video provides step-by-step instructions on how to create a MECO chart with ThinkCell. A MECO chart, sometimes also called Marimekko chart, is a two-dimensional stacked chart. In this chart type, not only the height, but also the width of a segment conveys information. ThinkCell offers two types of MECO charts: MECO charts with percent axis, and MECO charts with units. In this tutorial, we will have a look at a use case for each type to demonstrate which purposes the MECO chart can serve. Let's say you would like to show both the relative significance of individual regional markets for a number of companies and the importance of each company in the total market in a single chart. This can be done using a MECO chart with percent axis. It works like a standard 100% chart vertically, but also renders the absolute column totals horizontally through varying widths of the columns. In our example, a column's width shows the total revenue of that company and thus its share in the total market. You can immediately see that 21% of company Y's revenue in Asia is roughly the same absolute amount as 68% of company Z's revenue in America, shown by the similar area of both segments. To insert a MECO chart with percent axis, go to the ThinkCell group in the PowerPoint ribbon, open the Elements menu, and select MECO percent axis. Click on the slide to place the chart. The default data sheet takes percentage values and has a separate width row for the absolute totals of each column. Type in your data, starting with the company names as category labels. Then add the market regions for the series labels, and insert the total revenue of each company into the width row. Finally, type in the percentage values. Resize the chart if necessary. Multi-select the segment labels, and pick your preferred option from the label content control. You can choose between displaying absolute values, relative values, or both, the name of the series, or a combination of the series name with absolute or relative values. Now your MECO chart with percent axis is complete. Let's assume that you would like to create a chart that shows the total revenue of a concert hall in terms of its three seat categories. This can be done by using a MECO chart with units. The area of each segment instantly conveys the absolute revenue for each seat category. Each segment area is the product of the number of seats and price per seat. Furthermore, the total area of all MECO segments visually represents the total revenue itself. To insert a MECO chart with units, open the Elements menu, select MECO Unit Axis, and click onto the slide. First, enter the names of the seat categories into the category row of the datasheet. Then type in the number of available seats for each category in the X extent row. Finally, enter the price for each seat category in the first series row. If you would like to have different colors for each column, use a separate series row for each category. Right-click into the chart to remove the total labels and add segment labels instead. Insert a Y-axis to your MECO by right-clicking on the chart and selecting Add Y-axis from the context menu. Right-click on the axis itself and pick Add Title to name the axis. Repeat this for the X-axis, and feel free to add other features, like tick marks, via the right-click menu. Multi-select the category labels, and change the label content if you prefer to display both the category name and the number of seats. resize the chart if necessary. To highlight the outline of your MECO chart, right-click onto the chart and select Add Ridge from the context menu. To remove the ridge, select it with your mouse and hit the Delete key. Now you are done. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please visit our website for more ThinkCell tutorials.